Little pickle. Yes, guys. Little pickle. Big pickle. Little pickle. Big pickle. Little pickle. Big pickle. Pickle Rick. Little pickle. Big pickle. Pickle Rick. Little pickle. Pickle Rick. Let's go.
Let's go.
Yes, guys.
Hey guys, welcome back to another video. I'm once again joined by Big Pickle.
Thank you, Little Pickle. And now we're troving or wandering through, checking out the deals, and we're trying to figure out whether or not, you know, we've looked before at the dollar store hockey bags, but what can you find if you go through the collection of options when it comes to the Pokemon stuff? You got three premier cards, you got four trading cards, or a bag of 15 trading cards. Well, can we find anything good in any of these packs? We're just about to find it. Little Pickle is in raised spirits, as he always is. Why don't we try starting from the least expensive to the most expensive? We'll see if it works out that maybe, yes or no, whether the most expensive pack actually has the best stuff in it. You'd hope so. And whether or not you actually can get some sort of value from the other packs, or if it's just all throwaways. All right, so for my four trading cards, hopefully at least they're not all energies. There's no energy card. All right, that's a good start.
Eevee,
that's a good Pokemon.
Healing Scarf.
Mm-hmm.
Tangela. And Grookey Rapid Strike.
Alright.
For $1.25. Not too bad, maybe.
Got no hits per se, but some decent Pokemons in there, I would say. Alright. On to pack number two, which is the... Well, actually, this one might have the best stuff in it, because this one is claiming we're going to get premium cards, holos and rares. So let's see.
Armadillo,
okay. It's supposedly rare, I guess.
Marnie.
I guess it also rare. And?
Hollow Sand Shiny.
Hollow Sand Shiny.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And it was at a $250 price point, so it cost twice as much as the regular four trading card pack. And you get yourself a little shiny foily. So, Now, the big pack, get yourself 15 cards, but from within it, who knows what it'll be, and yes, probably a lot of the rules won't apply.
Aqua or water energy, I'm not sure. Mm-hmm. Leedian. Galarian Darmuka.
That's a new fucking card.
Purgly. Great Potion. Ball Guy. Glossflare.
Colorful, very nice.
Another energy.
I don't recall seeing...
That's an old...
Oh, I see. I was going to say, I guess we haven't opened up anything this old before, because all the energies look fairly similar, or this one looks extremely different format.
Flaffy.
Like a cloud.
Rhydon. Morpeku.
Oh, yeah, I think we've pulled that one before.
Leotard, that's a lot from Pokemon Go.
Nice.
Double Blade. Ooh, normal Grookey.
There you go.
And our final card, an energy.
Another energy. Alright, well.
Isn't it like more than the normal packs you would buy? For like more money?
Sorry, what are you saying about whether or not these dollar store packs cost more?
Yeah.
No, I think for a normal booster pack, it's probably around $6. You're getting more cards, but I guess you're kind of expecting within this pack you're not going to find anything too crazy. You're not going to find any V-Maxes or Vs or anything like that. But I don't know. It's hard to say as far as whether this is worse than a regular pack. Whether or not from these guys, if you got anything good. If spending $2.50 to get these three cards when you get one shiny in there. Whether or not if we bought more of these packs, I don't know. Would we actually come across something good? We know we didn't stumble across any gold here today. Was it all terrible? No, probably not. But some more Pokemons. You've gotten to see what you might find in some of these packs. So hopefully that's something that was interesting to everybody. Gotten a chance to compare one product versus the other. All three of the pristine options that are currently available anyways at the local Dollaramas around here. So anyway, little Peggle, what do you think?
Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Comment, like, and subscribe. Bye.